This is a role play developed as part of the course curriculum for Manage TB, an online course for doctors. The participants have enacted the roles given to them. The case discussed does not refer to any existing patient, but has been developed as part of the course curriculum. The investigations, such as x-rays and lab reports, used in this case scenario belongs to patients treated at National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis, Chennai. Their identity have been anonymized.
Good morning, madam.
Good morning, Pratiksha.
Ma'am, I have a case for discussion. Can we start now?
Yeah, yes, you can go ahead.
And this is about a 20-year-old pregnant lady. She's in the first trimester. She's a software engineer. She has the complaints of persistent cough for more than 20 days. She has fever for 3 weeks, which is intermittent. She had 2 episodes of spotting of blood in sputum. She's a non-diabetic and sputum smear is positive for acid fast bacilli. And the expert results have just now come in. MTB detected and it is sensitive to rifampicin.
Have you collected any more information?
Yeah, ma'am. I've asked her about any past anti-TB treatment, but she said she has not taken any treatment. She is non-reactive for HIV. She has no other concomitant illness and is not on medications, any other medications. She is not a diabetic. She is pregnant for 10 weeks now. Okay. And I've examined her. She weighs around 38 kg. She's not anemic, not jaundice, and there is no fetal edema.
So what treatment for TB would you like to prescribe for this patient?
She's newly diagnosed TB. She doesn't have any previous treatment history and she's sensitive to rifampicin. So I would like to start her with the 6-month daily regimen. The 2 months will be intensive phase and 4 months will be the continuation phase. During the intensive phase, she will receive isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide and ethambutol, and during the continuation phase she will receive isoniazid, rifampicin and ethambutol.
Good. But you said she is in the first trimester of pregnancy.
Yes,
so are these drugs safe?
Yes, ma'am. Except streptomycin, all other first like drugs are safe in pregnancy. And for any person, if during the first line treatment, if they become pregnant, except streptomycin, all other drugs can be continued.
Okay, good. Okay, what about the second line drugs? Are they safe in pregnancy?
Ma'am, it is better to avoid pregnancy while they are on second line TB treatment. But we should counsel them that they should avoid pregnancy if they are on second line TB treatment. But however, if the patient becomes pregnant and if the pregnancy is less than 20 weeks of duration, we should give them an option for medical termination of pregnancy, that is NTP. And if they are willing to do NTP, we can start or restart the treatment after NTP. But if the patient is not willing for NTP, then we have to, if the pregnancy is less than 12 weeks, then we have to substitute kanamycin and ethionamide with para-aminosalicylic acid. And if it's more than 12 weeks, only kanamycin alone can be omitted and substituted with para-aminosalicylic acid. If the pregnancy is for more than 20 weeks, then kanamycin can be substituted for para-aminosalicylic acid, and after delivery, kanamycin can be added to the regimen.
Yeah, you have very well outlined the management of TB in pregnancy. Okay. But how will you manage if in a mother who is lactating?
Ma'am, we should ask them to continue the anti-TB medications along with breastfeeding also.
Okay. And in addition, you must also counsel her on cough hygiene, not to cough when she is feeding the baby, so that to avoid transmission.
Okay.
And also you must screen the newborn for active TB and also offer isoniazid prophylaxis once you rule out active TB.
Okay, ma'am.
So now can you outline the most important points?
Sure, ma'am. First line anti-TB drugs except streptomycin are safe in pregnancy. Patient should be advised to avoid pregnancy while on anti-TB treatment. Breastfeeding should not be discontinued during anti-TB treatment. Cough hygiene should be advised in lactating women with TB. Newborn should be screened for active TB and offered isoniazid prophylaxis.